Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining IPv5. When we talk about IP, the most common thing that comes to mind is IP version 4. This is the version of the internet protocol that uses the dotted decimal format that we are so used to. I'm sure all of us have also heard about IP version 6 as well, the version of IP that the whole world is slowly but surely migrating to. But whatever happened to IP version 5? Well, IP version 5 isn't what you might expect based on the natural progression of the internet protocol. The version 5 designation was allocated to an experimental non-IP based streaming protocol called Internet Stream Protocol. And this was developed in the 1970s and it was later refined in the 1990s. Its official designation is ST2, and it was intended for connection-oriented communication, specifically for audio and video transmission. Now, the protocol itself was never officially designated as IPv5. Indeed, the term IPv5 has no official standing whatsoever. The reason why we skipped version 5 in the progression of IP versions is due to the fact that the ST2 protocol was assigned the number 5 in the version field of the IP header. So when we look at the header of an IPv4 or IPv6 packet, we see that there's a version field that indicates the version of IP that's being used. As you can see here, for both IPv4 and IPv6, the version field is the very first field in the header, and for good reason. By reading this field, which is composed of the very first bits of the packet that arrives on an interface, the network device reads the version and knows how to interpret the rest of the header and the rest of the packet. Now, because ST2 packets have the same structure as IP packets, engineers decided to use the version number 5 in the version field to distinguish ST2 packets from IPv4 packets, so they can be interpreted and processed accordingly. As soon as the network device receives that first header value, it knows how to interpret the rest of the packet accordingly. So because the value of 5 has already been taken by the ST2 protocol, the successor to IP version 4 thus had to be named IP version 6 to eliminate any possible confusion about the actual protocol in use. Thus, the designation IPv5 was effectively skipped over. Now, the Internet Stream Protocol was only experimental in nature, and it was never actually introduced for public use. However, many of the concepts available in ST2 are similar to other technologies that later emerged, including asynchronous transfer mode, or ATM, as well as multi-protocol label switching, or MPLS. ST2 was also a precursor to voice over IP, although it was never directly related with this technology. Now, all of these are technologies that we'll be talking about in future videos, so stay tuned for those. If you want to learn more about the ST2 protocol, the official definition of this protocol can be found in several published RFCs. These RFCs and other related links are found in the description below. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below. And please subscribe to get updates to all of my newly published videos. This is Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.